What they were doing, we're reading the Quran in Surah Jumu'ah, chapter 62, verse 5, that Allah respect them as a donkey. That these people, they were carrying a tons of book, but they understand nothing. And they were looking down to the Arabs, that these Arabs, they marry their stepmothers. They buy their children. They do fighting for unnecessary reasons. And these people, they worship 360 gods in the Kaaba that we have present today. So how these people, the arrogant nations, they will understand the message of Islam? So they restrain themselves from not giving the message of Allah to them. So Allah also changed the people of Bani Israel, and He chooses the people always from the people whom the other people are looked down upon. The Arabs were looked down upon by the Jews. Even the master historian, if you know Thomas Carlyle, he described that these Arabs, he told them, this human group, almost without sin. And you cannot distinguish these people from the animal except their form. So the Arabs, they were, in the early Arabs, they were like the animals in their nature, except the form, they are like human. But he says that a poor shepherd people roaming unnoticed since the creation of the world. So no nation or no emperor have ever tried to rule the Arabs, because they are an arrogant nation. The Persian, they passed them by. The Egyptian, they passed them by. Alexander the Great, they passed them by. It was a liability of any emperor to rule the Arabs. But a mercy prophet was sent down before them. See, the unnoticeable become world notable. The small become great. Within a century afterward, Arabia, it grammar lie in this hand and Delhi in another. Glancing color in the light of a genius, Arabia shines to a great extent in the world. Belief is great, so let it be as you believe. The history of a nation becomes fruitful. So the Arabs' history, Allah give them the torch bearer so that they can torch the whole world with the deen of Allah. This is the mood that we have got. So these people, the Arabs, the Arabian people, Allah changed them with the help of the Quran and with our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So right now, it is also a message for us. If we think that how these Swedish people, the adulterer especially, they drink in the Friday and Saturday nights, and we see them, they are very peculiar and ridiculous people, how they will understand the message of Allah? But Allah says, if I can change your ancestors, I can also change them. So it is a message for us that we should try also to change the community that we live. By Allah, it's very easy if Allah helps us. If we can just portray the message of Islam, inshallah, inshallah, this community, we will get the major rivers from this community, inshallah. So these are the examples that have been given in the Quran. And Allah says, use the hikmah. Now, how do we use the hikmah? The question that is always being rendered before us, that how can we portray the message of Islam? You see, we are in a major community here. Different community, we live different people. We interact with different people. So whenever we meet different people, we try to identify that what is his point of view and how far he knows about Islam. What is his questions? Because the media, they are giving wrong pictures of Islam. So people always ask, why you wear the cap? Why you have a beard? Why don't you eat pork? Why don't you eat? Why don't you drink alcohol? Why don't you mix up with girls? And why don't you do that? So many questions. So now we have to have a very basic answer with the scientific reasons, with the reasons of the present society, and with the religious guidance, so that we can give them the picture of different angles. Whatever they suit, they may be a religious person, it can suit them. They may be an atheist who will believe about only logic. So we can convince them with the logic. There might be some other people who will be convincing about medical aspects or the social systems. So whichever part that we can portray them, we should try to portray them so that according to their understanding level, they understand that what is Islam. And now if we go back to the history, that how our Prophet ﷺ, he understood the message. At the age of 60, while he may think to keep rest with his grandchildren, but Allah, he sends revelation through Archangel Jibreel ﷺ. You find it in Surah Sabah, chapter 34, verse 28, that وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ, that, O Prophet, I have not revealed you but for the mercy of the whole of mankind. Bashira, giving glad tidings, wa nazira, and giving warning. Walakil aksar nas la ya'lamun, but the bulk of mankind yet do not know. And we find still today that people do not know. They wanted to know what is Islam. So what our Prophet did? He immediately called the scribes, those who can writing letters. He wrote 5 letters immediately to the king of Persia, the king of Yemen, the emperor of Egypt, Nagas of Abyssinia, and Constantinople, with 5 horsemen going 1,000 miles east, 1,000 miles west. And in the Hajjatul Bida, the last pilgrimage of the Prophet, he was addressing about 110,000 Sahabas. The Prophet was telling them, and every Sahaba was crying. The Prophet says, I may not be with you in the next Hajj, but I am giving you a responsibility. Those who are present here, it is your responsibility to convey my message to those who are not present here. And he says, do you understand? So all the Sahabas, this is Bishak, we understand. And out of 110,000 Sahabas, less than 10,000 were buried in Arabia. Alhamdulillah, they spread throughout the world and they converted and they reverted our ancestors. So somehow we now can practice this deen of Allah. So this is the message that the Prophet ﷺ, he gave us this responsibility to. Allah also says, you have this responsibility too. Now, wherever we go, we always try to follow the commandments of Allah and His Messenger. So we spread out, the Muslims spread out. Now we Muslims, alhamdulillah, we do not have any problem in this community. In the Constitution of Sweden, if you read in their second chapter, the basic rights and principles, in Article 2 to 4 and including 20, that it is the fundamental and basic rights of every people living in Sweden to preach, practice and propagate his religion. So constitutionally, we have rights, but we are not using the rights that has been given by the Constitution in Sweden. In Sweden, they have a freedom of speech. As long as we follow the Quran, whatever the truth that Allah given to us, we can portray to them. We can send them this message that this is the haq that we have, and now we are presenting in the best manner that we can. Now it is up to you whether you accept it or not, but at least we can open our mouth. So, alhamdulillah, we have so many mosques, alhamdulillah, here in Sweden. You see, I was in my home and I met some of the small cults of Christianity. They call this Jehovah's Witness. They knock the doors of the Muslims, especially the students, those who came from abroad. And they are giving pamphlets, posters to propagate their faith. With the falsehood, they are walking in the street. They are taking the benefits. The Mormon churches, every Mormon, they spend 2 years of missionary works. They knock the door of the people, they catch the people in the street, and they propagate their faith. We know that they are in the wrong track, but still they are in the marketplace. So even if we know the Muslims, if we go to Kalibari market, we find that Qadianis, the deviated sects from the Islam, they are still working there. I was shocked in Saturday and Sunday. I see they are selling more than 20 to 30 Quran in the Swedish translations. And we know that is just deceiving to the people. And what we Muslims are doing. So with the wrongs, the people are working. But with the truth, we have to make some movement in the community that we live. So we have initiated, as you know, the Islamic Propagation Center, alhamdulillah, in the last March, just to have this concept clear to this community as long as we are here. But it is up to you, my brothers, because you're going to live here for a long time. So you have to build a strong community with knowledge, with technology, with education, with reasoning, with logic, and everything that you can according to your ability to arm yourself to do works in this community. This is a liberty, this is a privilege as given by Allah that you should share your deen to the others. So, wherever you go, if you work in a company, or you are a student like me, or you are a businessman, wherever you can, we can try our level best to convey this message of Islam. We can give an elaborate description that what Islam stands for. It is not a religion, but it's a complete way of life. It has the solution to all the problems. Maybe as a layman, I may not be able to give answers at the present time, but we can go to home, we can find the answers. We know various Islamic websites are there, and we can give them the messages.